It was a send-off befitting a cultural maven whose invaluable contribution to the arts transformed St. Lucia's folk music landscape. The life and times of Denise Joyce Auguste were celebrated in the songs she helped cultivate, hymns to the soundtrack of the authentic St. Lucian experience. Homage was paid with recitations from the music archive of the Hewanorra Voices. The strumming guitar solo of longtime friend Ronald Boo Hingson sobbed in melodious notes to the fallen legend. The eulogy was delivered by another close friend, Winston Springer Sr. He says attempts to chronicle the story of Joyce Auguste in her own words through a TV interview series was dashed by the all-too-common myopic lens of partisan politics.
Joyce had planned to participate in a series of programs entitled Extraordinaire that I, Winston Springer, was producing, dedicated to the extraordinary St. Lucians who have lived extraordinary lives in service to their country. Among them, Charles Cadet, Ronald Boo Hingson, Lawrence Laurent, Calix George Sr., and Rick Wayne, to name a few. But as fate would have it, it was not to be. Because of the divisiveness of partisan politics, fueled by the myopia of a politician who could not see the bigger picture. As a result, an opportunity was lost to have Joyce tell her story in her own words.
Springer, who spoke of the icon with veneration, bemoaned that his friend's voice fell silent to Father Time before she could have regaled generations anew of her devotion to God and country.
Oh, there was so much she had to say and wanted to say. History is not for us to like or dislike. It is there for us to learn, not to erase or edit to our liking. It is my sincere hope that we will have a chance to hear from people like Calix George Sr. on the history of agriculture, having already written the history of St. Mary's College. Michael Chastney Sr. tell the story of the coasting boats, canneries, Michael David, the Jewel and others. Kenneth Moplesey on arts, the law on the Banana Growers Association. MacDonald Dixon on the days when blacks were not employed in the banks here. Mac has a lot to say. You could trust me on that. Then there is Alpha Jacobs, Guy Ellis, Julian Hunt, the present Governor General, Sir Neville Snack, and many others, including Mr. Arnott Valmore, the only living indigenous business person who will turn 100 years this year.
Musical sets and cultural presentations were interwoven into the tapestry of the celebration of life. While politicians delivered platitudes, men of the cloth sought to interpret the word of God in the life and death of celebrated souls.
But as so many of you know, Joyce died with a pain in her heart, a pain about so many things. Let us not die with pain in our hearts. St. Lucia, let not your cultural activists, let not your musicians, your poets, your painters die for pain in their heart. Let's not give them a beautiful funeral after they have died, but let's give them a life now while they're still alive.
Joyce Auguste is in the pantheon of St. Lucian greats whose commendations did not fully capture the magnitude of her outsized influence on society. As the number of trailblazers dwindle with each passing day, renewed calls are being made to archive their lived experience for posterity. Joachim de Plessis, HTS News Force.